I was almost not gonna go, and I said, goddamn, get out there. You gotta get some more content on your channel. I was supposed to do the road trip, you know, with the rig and the dirt bike, but I wasn't feeling it, so I didn't do it. You know what I'm saying? I mean, I've got the Crawford fight this weekend. I really want to watch that baby. I could have watched it out there in the jungle. Possibly. It would have probably been a broken stream, though. A lot of interference a lot of buffering. So it probably wouldn't have been very good, but I would have had both my phones going. So with any luck at all, one could have been buffering. Maybe the other one, another server could have been good. You know what I'm saying? If there were two servers during that fight. Usually it has to be a really big pay-per-view fight in order to get multiple servers, like three of them. Does that make sense, guys? Let's see what this bike lane is all cracked up to be, guys. No cars coming. I'm gonna switch a couple lanes here. Oh. Looks like a security guard right there. High profile, high rent district here. Tell me you're not enjoying this ride. Come on, guys. I think the angle's good on there. That wide angle lens is definitely a... Oh, a lot of these hunters, they have the same thing as this. They have a GoPro. They usually have a cameraman with a really good camera. But sometimes you have the solo hunter dude, like Remy Warren or Tim Perkett. But anyways, these guys have their camera. You know, they might have their a slot on their vest where they can put the camera when they can't hold it. Then they've got their GoPro on their hat, you know, on a headband like I have. And, you know, the thing is, this is all, a lot of this stuff is GoHunt.com. So they supply them with all the cameras and all some of these solo hunters. And they just put all the filming together. GoHunt.com does all the editing for them. They get paid big bucks to use prime bows. Well, you know, I don't know what they make, but they probably make pretty good money. You know what I'm saying? I don't know how many people, hunters, GoPro doc, GoHunt.com employs, but it seems to me like they employ quite a few hunters. You know, you've got Matthews, Bose, Hoyt, Prime is big. They're doing a lot of advertising. You see them using Prime bows, you know, with a big Prime sticker on the bow so they get good advertising. I think the Matthews has pretty much got the drop on everybody. They probably make the best bow. Matthews and Hoyt. There's quite a few. There's like 10 different compound bow manufacturers that make a pretty good product. They cost anywhere from say $1,200 to $1,900 for a Matthews compound bow lift, compound bow. I wouldn't mind getting one of those cocksuckers, man. When you're camping, you can set that bow up and you know, target shoot. You know, get your skills down where you can hit a 3-inch cluster at 40 yards. Get some good arrows. A nice coast down this sucker, man. Damn, I enjoy that coast down. It's beautiful. Yeah, you can spend some serious money on a bow. Serious money. I've priced them out. All, everything that you need, arrows, a lot of guys, they do their own arrows, but I would just buy mine, of course. Arrows aren't cheap, man. You could pay $200 for 6 of them, or you can get cheaper ones for maybe $100. But when you pay $200 for 6, they are pretty fucking tight. Straight as an arrow, no pun intended. The weight of all the tips and everything is like almost identical from one tip to the next to the next. The arrow weight is almost identical from one to the next to the next. Straight. Crazy, man. It's crazy, crazy. You could drop easy with sights and 6-pack arrow quiver. I'm trying to think of some of the stuff you need to have to get a good bow, compound bow. And the compound bow, man, you have to have it. You'll have to have a, you know, you got to figure out what, how many pound draw you want. You know what I'm saying? Up 50, up to 80 pounds of draw. I don't know. I guess that wouldn't be, you'd have to take a bow and see what works best for you. they put the timer on this one. This one guy's channel was Phelps. He does the Phelps collars. That's his family business. But his buddy had a draw pull for about 2.5 minutes. He was expecting to shoot a bull. So you want, if you can pull that, do the draw before the bull gets into the picture for the shot. So he pulled the, he did the draw on the bow and he held it for 2.5 minutes. And he couldn't hold it any longer. But I would dare to say it's a compound bow. So it's not like you have to hold the whole 70 pounds. You only have to hold like 20% of it, but still 80 pounds, whatever you had. You have to get a poundage that you're comfortable to be able to hold. You gotta be able to pull it back, hold it. If you can hold it for a minute, comfortably, you should be okay. You may have to also train, go into training for that. Make sure that you're trained to do that. You would have to work out so you can do it comfortably. Get tuned into Wilderness Athlete and it'll give you a series of exercises that you need to do to, before bow season, be in shape for it. The hiking, the bow work, pulling, all kinds of shit like that, you know what I'm saying? It'll get you in shape. It'll get you in shape for the hunt. Does that make sense, kids? All right, man, we've got to get a little bit of dirt travel in. Make sure that everybody's happy on my channel so they don't ask me why I don't go off on dirt trails. So here we go. We'll get all of those trolls off my back. Cloudy day today. Yeah, I'm getting the itch to get out of town. None of my cars are rented now. They're all sitting in the garage or in my driveway. I had a reasonably good month last month renting the cars, so that was kind of nice. I'd like to have another good month these next couple of months. August is generally not too good, but September and October are usually pretty good months for car rentals. But I'd like to have it a good August. We got off to it's only August 2nd, guys, so the cars have been all three of the cars were rented. So I do have a good start for the month. I mean, the money came in August for the cars, two of them. I'll get paid today probably on two of the cars, car rentals, or one. I got paid for one yesterday, and I'll probably get paid for another one today. So it's a good start to the month when you got a couple hundred bucks already in the bank. Coming through. Stop and ponder this for half a second. Could it kill you? It's overcast skies today. Humid. Probably about six, quarter to six or so, if I had to take a guess. It's not important. You know, I guess there's a thing I can set the time on here, but I'm not a big fidgeteer. So, now see, I know the camera's too high now. But if I can shut this light off. What time you got?
Oh, I don't know.
All right, no worries. I can't, the camera's definitely too high at this point, but once I start riding, then it's too low. Thank God you got a wide angle. How you doing, man? It's overcast, so what the fuck? I'd say it's... ...6 o'clock. You'll see the sun came up already for sure, but it's behind those clouds. Jeep all ready to go. Trailer's ready. All I gotta do is load up the rig and put the dirt bike on. You always want to do that the day before you go. So it's parked in the driveway, ready to go. You don't want to be doing that shit the morning of. That stuff's got to be done. So when you leave, you're not taxed by doing all that loading. That takes time. When you wake up, you want to just go. Put the food in the Jeep and go. Does that make sense, guys? One. Well, I sure hope that lens is clean. There's some graffiti down there. No sidewalk, just desert. Oh, there is a sidewalk right there. Okay, we'll take it. We'll stay on this side. There was only desert terrain there. Let's take a ride by the Jeep dealership. I'll show you a blue Wrangler 392, and they got a black one too. At least they did it yesterday or 2 days ago. I would never get black. It's too hot, and it's shiny, black. You don't want that. That's a lot of fucking headaches. Keeping that fucker clean and keeping surface scratches off of it. Now, I've got a black Jeep, but it's matte black. And most of it is black armor paint. I've got scratches all over that thing, but all those scratches are character scratches. I've got a badass Jeep, I don't mind saying so myself. Okay, what is this guy doing? Is he on Quaaludes, prostitution? My favorite Roberto's Taco Shop, which I have not eaten at in a very long time. I've got to go to the doctor this coming up week. So I'm trying to stay plant-based food. Even though I think it takes like 3 months to if you got cholesterol in your blood, it takes about three months to get that shit out. Technically speaking, of course. I mean, it's not gonna come out. It's not gonna come out in 2 weeks, you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna pass you, sir. Thank you, you're good. Thank you. I don't know, man, when you're doing two-thirds of your diet, when two-thirds of your diet is vegan, when you have no cholesterol in your refrigerator, you have no fucking cholesterol in your refrigerator, no processed foods, no soda, you're not doing too bad. And you're taking fish pills and fucking red yeast rice and vitamin D. It's gonna be interesting to see. But you know, here's where you, this is where you run into a potential deal on a Jeep, where someone, a lot of people buy Jeeps. A lot of people buy Jeeps and they don't like them. After they buy them, they're like, what the fuck was I thinking? So they trade them back in to other dealerships, you know, like. They might have sold that blue one. They had a bunch of them here. They had a bunch of Jeeps and they did sell them. Even a this, they had a pink one and it sold. Oh, here we go. Here's the rubies. Oh, let's go down here and take a look at the whole inventory. Morning.
Morning.
Got any 392s?
You know what, I think we have one up there out of court.
Okay, thank you. You too. Yeah, the old, oh, is this a 392? Yeah, this is the black one they have. They have a white one, black one, and then they have the blue. Black 392. Winch. This dealer, though, they're rip-offers. They do not haggle. I tried to buy a Jeep off these guys before I bought my Jeep. They would not budge. They were trying to screw me every which way up and down. So I was glad to be able to call them back and say I bought the one in Birmingham, Alabama. This ain't bad. You got a winch, front bumper. You're gonna change the bumper, put a stubby on. Only 35 inch tires. You gotta put a lift kit on this beast. I think it's 102,000. Oh, it's got the power steps on the side, rock slider power steps. I think that's what those are. This is the 392 Final Edition, 2024. you could put a lift kit on it, change the rear bumper, wheels and tires. The window sticker is probably on the floor in there. They don't put it on the window because it blocks their view, people's view. It's got the hard top. She ain't a bad rig, man. But man, my dogs would fuck that up in a minute. In a New York minute. Like I said, this dealer doesn't haggle on price. They try to fuck you. Excuse my French. Did I say that? That is a beautiful rig though. You put a lift kit on that beast, you're gonna have yourself one hell of a little pop. One hell of a little pimp. It'd be a badass Jeep, but that black is such a bitch. I'm gonna go take one last look at it. I've got a Earl colored one in Idaho. I do have a Anvil colored one in Idaho, brand new. And they also have a white one up there, and they have a I think that's it for now. But they don't have any of this final edition. You know, for Chapman to get, they had like fucking four or five final editions, right? To get that many, you gotta be a big time dealer. And this dealer here is a big, they got multiple dealerships across the town. Look at this, see this? Look at this, that's pink. That's Tuscadero color. I call it pink. That reddish, pinkish one right there. That's Tuscadero. Okay, looks like... looks like they sold the blue one. The service thing is open. There's a Tuscadero one. Oh, look at that shit. Not that I would get this, but look at that financing. Man, if you can get that type of financing. You won't get that type of financing on the fucking 392, that's for sure. These guys do the work. Well, they did it when my truck Jeep was on warranty. There's a blue one over here. Let's take a ride around this corner here. I don't think it's the new one. I think the ones over there are used ones. Boy, that black one's tits, isn't it? Doesn't it get your mouth drooly, watery? Let's see, look at here across the street. See, that's a trade-in over there, that Jeep. That's where you might be able to catch a fucking badass Jeep. Oh, check this out, 2.9% for 84 months. That's fucking outrageous. How you doing, boss? You don't see that 2.9 on the fucking... on the 392s. There's another pink one, Tuscadero. Those are for the women jeepers of the world. I don't think a guy would buy that Tuscadero. I didn't know what color. I had to pull it up on the computer. I said, what the fuck color is that? They say it's a red, but that's, I don't care what the fuck you call it, that's pink. Where I come from, that's pink. Let's go see what's going on here at the Tobin Dodge dealer. I tell you what, man, this place here, they seem depleted here. But this is the place that really grabs your attention with all these fucking Challengers and shit, Chargers. Oh, check this fucker out. I just like looking at them. I love looking at these. This is 2024. I think they quit making the 392. There's a 392 Hemi. Fluorescent green. Yeah, these guys are depleted. They usually, look at all this shit here is usually full of cars. I would imagine that's used right there. Somebody traded it in, got tired of it. They're usually packed in here. They've had a good sales month last month. Good old Tobin Dodge. GoPro, stop recording. GoPro, stop recording.